What is up, guys? Salamander here. We are here, back for another Oktoberfest fun game known as The Walking Dead. Now, this is going to be Season 1. Now, one of the major reasons I also been wanting to play a lot of scary games for you guys is so I could play this game and try to reach all the way up to Season 3. That's going to take some doing. Hopefully, it'll work. But without further ado, let us get started. This is going to be an interesting ride. Now, Dying Light is gonna be still a thing. I'm gonna keep doing the same thing that I've been. Oh, player is saved. Would never. Player saved. Progress is saved when this indicator is displayed. Please do not power off the console while the indicator is on screen. Cool. So Dying Light is still gonna be a thing. I'm gonna be doing the same thing I've been doing with, like, you know, Assassin's Creed Revelations, and Batman Arkham Knight, which I'm gonna be playing one game one time, and the next time I stream, I'll play a different game. I'll probably get back to Dying Light, I'll get back to Dying Light because that's probably the only other scary game that I have that's not multiplayer based. Unless, you know, my friend Brendan gets here at some point and then we'll be playing maybe some Dead by Daylight. I don't know. It's all about playing the scary games today and, well, actually this whole month, so hopefully you guys enjoyed. I played Dying Light earlier, a few hours ago, and I'm back. I took a little nap. And I'm like, you know what, I still have some time to actually stream, so let's stream right now. And without further ado, let's get started with The Walking Dead. I've already played this game before. Which is display style standard. More helpful from UI and feedback when you make important choices. Minimal turn off UI units, help and choice notifications. I don't know what that means. Oh, okay. Yeah, this is much. Now, what I'm trying to see here is, I can play them all. Okay, cool. Because the whole collection of The Walking Dead, I was going to say Assassin's Creed. We're not playing Assassin's Creed right now, we're playing The Walking Dead. So this is going to be episode 1. Hopefully you guys enjoyed. Or enjoy, I should say. The game series adapts to the choices you make. The story is tailored by how you play. You've seen my streams, you should already know how much I love Telltale games. Oh dude, I should download The Wolf Among Us. Oh dude, that's a game to play. I haven't played it at all, so. It's gonna be interesting. The Walking Dead. It's like I just pops up there for you. Episode 1, A New Day. So this is one of the first, one of the first famous Telltale games. When it was based off a famous TV series / comic book. And, it's pretty amazing. Awkward silence.
Well, I reckon you didn't do it then.
Alright, hold that thought. I hate it when that happens. Alright, helps and options. Settings. Audio visual. Where are the subtitles? Brightness, that's fine. Music, voice, sound. Gameplay. There we go, subtitles. Apply that shit. We want subtitles here, damn it. It's a lot prettier when it's in subtitles, in my opinion. Ah, resume game.
Dan.
What do you say that?
Why do you say that?
You know, I've driven a bunch of fellas down to this prison. Lord knows how many. Usually it's about now I get the, I didn't do it.
Say.
And what do you say?
I say, yep, I know you didn't.
We got what looks like a 1091E near P3X-35. All cars asked to keep on the lookout for 91B.
I followed your case a little bit. You being a Macon boy and all.
You're from Macon then?
You're from Macon then.
Yep, came up to Atlanta to be a city cop in the 70s. Always wanted to work a murder case. Like that senatorial mess you got yourself mixed up in. With all due respect. A real shame, that is.
Hello.
Hell, the whole family used to be regulars at your folks' drugstore right in downtown. Still there?
Sure is.
Good.
I'm just trying to be calm about this.
I got a nephew up at UGA. You teach there long?
Going on my 6th year.
You meet your wife in Athens?
Doesn't want to talk about it.
You want to know how I see it?
Sure.
Sure.
Regardless, could be you just married the wrong woman.
You see, thank you. Or she married the wrong guy.
I'm driving this man once. He was the worst one. He wouldn't stop going on about how he didn't do it. He was an older fella, big soft eyes behind a pair of smart folk glasses. And he just wailing back there. Says it wasn't him. Crying and snotting all over right where you're sitting.
Gross.
Then before long, he starts kicking the back of the seat like a fussy baby on an airplane. Tell him he's got to stop. That's government property. And I'll be forced to zap him otherwise. So he stops, and having exhausted all his options, he starts crying out for his mama. Mama, it's all a big mistake. It wasn't me.
So did he do it?
They caught the fucker red-handed, stabbing his wife, cutting her up as the boys came through the door. He sits in my car screaming bloody murder that it wasn't him. I think he actually believed it himself. It goes
to show someone's freaking out.
People will up and go mad when they believe their life is over. I got another good one for you. This one's a little bit less depressing and a bit more hilarious, if I do say so.
Watch out!
Other time.
Oh, shit. Well, that was a quick, easy game. Looks like we are dead now. But are we the Walking Dead? That's a real question. Nah, we're not dead. And they're gonna kill the main character in the first episode. Come on now. It's been a while since I've played this game. Never streamed it for you guys, but that's been a while.
Officer, are you all right? I'm still cuffed back here.
Why the hell did he have his gun out?
Why wouldn't he have his gun out, bro? There we go. Dude. For a guy with a broken leg, he sure has a bunch of fucking strength in that other leg. What did it take? 4 kicks? Use the left stick to move along the car. I love reading instructions.
Easier to carry with these cuffs off.
Well, still. Let me pick this shit up. The shotgun shell. I'm sure you can pick it up. If you picked up that shotgun, you can pick this shit up too. Now, can I go here and pick this up? I've never done it this way before, so.
Looks empty. It'll be easier to carry with these cuffs off.
Are they really trying to make me take these cuffs off?
Officer?
Cuffs off. I was gonna say cuffs up. What? Can I even English right now? Oh, look, keys. Right in the man's ass. Oh.
Shit.
Alright. I don't know why he reacted that way if he doesn't know anything about the walkers yet.
Officer.
Hey, buddy. Whoa!
Holy shit!
Oh, can I look?
What in the hell?
Oh, shit.
Get away from me!
You guys are a pretty good distance.
Who the hell are you?
Did he say who the hell are you or what the hell are you?
Don't make me do this!
Well, it's gonna be done. Nice. Gross, but nice.
Man.
I don't sound as scared, but there's gonna be moments where I'm like, oh,
help! Go get
ooh,
someone!
Out of the frying pan.
There's been a shooting!
Freed from your cuffs, bud. I just realized who that was. I thought that was a zombie, but I just realized who that was. Oh, don't keep moving. Wait. Oh. Oh, fuck. That was weird. That was a weird delay. God damn it. That's too early for the decay. That's my opinion. Zombies look like they've been... I'm sorry. These walkers look like they've been dead for quite a while. Find out who fired those shots. Oh, dude, English is so complicated right now. I just woke up from a nap, so I can't really talk properly.
Hello? Anybody?
What, can I go over here?
No ladder. I'm not getting up there anyway. This leg the way it is.
Anybody up there?
Answer me, damn it. No, I'm just kidding.
Help!
I wonder if anybody's home. I wonder if anybody's home.
Oh, that's just me saying that? Oh, I thought it was just a guy. I was walking up here.
Hello? Anybody home? I need a little help.
Alright.
Coming in. Don't shoot, okay? Not an intruder. Or one of them.
Whatever they are. Aha.
Are These people might need more help than I do.
Well, that's why we're here, right? Dude, that kid draws some badass unicorn. Man, I left my friend Ian was here.
Jesus.
You just saw it, right? Alrighty. Oh, dude, that's gross. I believe it's this one. There we go. Take it anyway. We don't care if this belongs to somebody. I know, me playing it kind of ruins the fun of it, but trust me, I haven't played the other seasons, so bear with me.
Three new messages. Message one, left at 5:43 p.m.
Hey, Sandra, this is Diana. We're still in Savannah. Ed had a little incident with some crazy guy near the hotel, so we had to get back to the ER and have it checked out. Anyway, he's not feeling well enough to drive back tonight, so we're staying an extra day. Thanks so much for looking after Clementine, and I promise we'll be back in time before your spring break.
Message 2. Left at 11:19 p.m.
Oh my god, finally. I don't know if you tried to reach us. All the calls are getting dropped. They're not letting us leave and aren't telling us anything about Atlanta. Please, please, just leave the city and take Clementine with you back to Murrieta. I've got to get back to the hospital. Please let me know that you're safe.
Message 3, left at 6:51 a.m.
Clementine, baby. We love you. We love you.
Three times. I said it three times. If she didn't get the message that they love her, I don't know if I will.
Daddy? House.
Hi, Clementine. I'm Lee.
You're not my daddy.
No, I'm not.
No, I'm not.
I was gonna be like, you're a little too young to say that word right now. Where are your parents?
Where are your parents?
They took a trip and left me with Sandra. They're in Savannah, I think, where the boats are.
Are you safe?
Are you safe?
I'm outside in my treehouse. They can't get in.
That's smart.
See? Can you see me? I can see you through the window.
Hey, sweetheart. Whoa! Hey, Sandra! Don't worry, it wasn't gonna hurt her. Little bee. Ow! Seriously, Lee, what the fuck? I thought the point of these guys was that they were slow. Hammer time, bitch! We had to make sure she had to die. Achievement! Adventures in Babysitting. Escape from Sandra and Maid Clementine.
Hi there.
Did you kill it?
Yeah, sure.
Yes.
It's okay. I think she was a monster.
Oh.
Yeah, I think so too. You've been all by yourself through this?
Yeah. I want my parents to come home now.
I would too.
I think that might be a little while, you know?
Oh.
Look, I don't know what happened, but I'll look after you until then.
Not creepy or anything.
What should we do now?
Alright, I'm gonna leave it up to you, viewer. Should I get out here when the sun goes down, or should I just look for help before it gets dark. Please respond, because I don't want to feel like I'm not talking to anybody. If you can't reply, if you can't, that's fine. I'll make my choice. Fulzenatoid? I can't really pronounce that. What do you think, buddy? What should I do? I am thinking looking for help before it gets dark, because sure, we can be spotted quicker, but you know, we can at least see where they're going.
We need to find help before it gets dark.
Yeah, it's not safe at night.
Let's go. Stay close to me.
All right, kid. Let's move out. I may not be that old, but I'm old enough not to catch up with you, kid, so slow down. Can I talk to you? Oh, no, I can't. I have to open the gates.
Oh, man.
I ain't never getting home to Mama at this rate.
This sucks.
Oh, it's hot dish night.
It's hot dish night? What kind of other dishes do you get?
What's the matter?
Should I stay?
What?
I don't want to sleep in the treehouse tonight, but I don't know if I should leave. What if my parents come home?
They won't. Let's go. I don't know.
Neither do I. Let's go somewhere safe that's close. Okay.
That's a good idea.
I don't want to point out that they're flat out dead. The thing I don't know seems to be the most.
Hey, man!
Appropriate.
Holy shit!
Don't
voice.
Eat us! We're not gonna hurt you.
Yeah. Thought for a second you and the little one were both gonna give us the chomp.
Huh.
We need help.
Are you trying to get out of here? Because you should be. Those things are all over the damn place. I haven't seen anything as gnarly as this neighborhood since downtown Atlanta, 15 miles back. I'm Sean.
You know what gnarly means.
Sean Green.
Lee, this is Clementine.
I'm Chet.
We shouldn't be out in the open like this. How about you help us clear the way, and we'll take you and your daughter out of here and down to my family's farm. It should be safer there.
I'm not a dad. I'm...
Let's be honest about it.
Just some guy.
Some dude.
Some guy?
Yeah.
She's alone? Let's get going. Staying put for too long is a mistake.
She's not alone now. She's with me.
What do you want to do?
I...
Oh.
The monster's come out.
We gotta go. Leave quick. Let's go.
Right, let's do this. Where's the person there? Getting redder. Shit. Yay! Clementine decided to join us! Alright. Fuck out. Good day, Clementine.
For just some guy, it seems like you saved a bunch of lives today.
Achievement yet again. In your charge. Found help and are now responsible for a little girl. That was inevitable. That's how this game works.
I'm gonna run on home. Nice to meet you both.
See you later, Chet.
Thank God you're okay. Past couple days, old Brecken down the way thinks his mare's gone lame, but that ain't nothing new.
I wouldn't have made it back without Chet.
Well, I'm glad you took him with you then. You've brought a couple guests.
We just
need a little help. We won't stay long.
Good. You're welcome to stay here, but just for the night. I don't run a bed and breakfast. So it's just you and your daughter, then?
Oh, not his daughter. He's, well, just some guy who found her alone.
Honey, do you know this man?
Yes.
Okay, then. Well, looks like you hurt your leg pretty bad there.
Yeah, it's not doing so good.
I can help you out. Sean, run on in and check on your sister. You, take a seat up on the porch and I'll go see what I have.
Wait, Sean has a sister? How come? Yeah, interesting. How come we never met
Let's
her?
Let's have a look. Yeah, this is swollen to hell.
It hurts like hell.
It hurts like hell.
I bet it does. What did you say your name was?
It's Lee.
It's Lee.
Nice to meet you, Lee. I'm Herschel Green.
Herschel!
How'd this happen?
A car accident.
Car accident.
That's so. Where were you headed before the car accident?
Out of Atlanta.
I was getting out of Atlanta.
The news says stay.
Yeah, well, that's a mistake. We hit a guy. One of those things you've been hearing about. On the road.
Who are you with, the girl?
A police officer.
A police officer. He was giving me a ride.
We're being completely
awful
honest here.
Nice of him.
I'm an awful nice guy.
House is full up with mine. We got another displaced family of three sleeping in the barn. You and your daughter are welcome to rest there when we're done here. I didn't get your name, darling.
Clementine.
Can't imagine what you've been through, Clementine.
I'm looking after her until we find her parents.
Hey, Dad, so I'm thinking, first thing tomorrow, we gotta reinforce the fence around the farm.
That doesn't seem necessary.
I don't know what you saw on TV or heard on the radio, but there's some serious shit hitting the fan. I don't think anyone knows how big it is yet.
Your son's right. You're going to want to fortify this place.
Stuff like that doesn't happen around here, Sean.
Dad, I'm serious. Lee, come on. Tell him what you saw out there, man.
Dead people walking.
I got chased by a couple of dead people.
Well, do what you think you should. We got plenty of chores as it is.
Lee and those folks in the barn can help out in the morning. We got to do it. Really.
I already said okay. Well, I'm all done here. It should start to feel better tomorrow.
Thanks.
If your leg gets hot or the swelling doesn't go down, you're probably dealing with an infection.
What do we do then?
We'll probably just have to shoot you.
In front of the kid. Really?
We'll clean it, redress it, and you'll be fine.
Okay, that'd be preferable.
That would be
very nice. There's blankets and such in the barn. We'll be seeing you bright and early. Come tomorrow, which way you think you're headed?
Towards Macon, I suppose. All right, then.
It smells like...
manure.
Manure? Like when a horse plops?
Just like that.
We're not gonna swear in front of the kid, even though some people are
there. Mom and Dad.
I bet, Clem.
How far is Savannah?
Pretty far.
Yep.
Oh, okay.
It's so far that it's pretty. Brandon, I freaking hate you right now.
I love you, baby.
Hello. Nightmare. Diversion, Brendan. What's up with that? Am I spoiling anything for you?
Hey, get up.
I'm itchy.
What do I not?
Well, you slept in a barn, little lady. Lucky you don't have spiders in your hair. But I bet your daddy scared them all away, huh?
I'm, not her dad. Name's Lee.
I'm Kenny.
Dad, we're in the middle of a fence. There's a tractor and everything.
We better get going, or we won't hear the end of it. That's my boy, Ken Jr. We call him Duck, though.
Duck?
Yeah, nothing bothers him. Like water off a duck's back, you know?
That's a valuable treat lately.
No kidding. But frankly, I think it's because he's dumb as a bag of hammers.
Dad!
But he makes up for it with enthusiasm.
It's nice to see a father calling his son
dumb. You were on your way
dumb.
To Macon.
My family's from there.
Well, Macon's on the way, and personally, I'd appreciate the company of a guy who can knock a couple of heads together if he has to.
I'll ask
the
girl.
What the girl would like.
Ah, gotta consult the missus. I understand. Honey, Duck, this is Lee. And, what's the girl's name?
Clementine.
Clementine.
That is a very pretty name.
Thanks.
Well, we should get to work. We've all seen what those things can do out there, so the faster we get this fence up, the better.
I want to build a fence.
Yeah? Well, I need a good foreman. You can sit on the tractor and yell at me whenever I take a water break.
On the tractor? Cool!
Duck and I will hop to it.
Oh, Duck.
I can keep an eye on your little girl here on the porch. We can visit.
All right, let's see. Clementine.
You having a nice time with Katya, Clementine?
Yeah.
Hey Katya. There, girls.
What do you do?
What do you do when corpses aren't walking around?
I'm a veterinarian back in Fort Lauderdale, like Herschel here, except more with dogs and cats and not horses. What is it that you do, Lee?
I used to teach up at the University of Georgia.
We need to hope that we can go back to our jobs soon, Lee. Back to normal. It can't stay like this.
Yeah, my mistake.
We'll all be home soon.
How was the city to actually look relaxed?
You two actually look relaxed.
I think we're doing just fine. Clementine was just telling me about first grade.
Oh, how's that?
It's easy.
Well, yeah.
Duh.
So, you good?
Anyway, it's almost like we didn't see people eating each other for the past 3 days. It's peaceful here, no?
How was the city?
How did you handle getting through the city?
Kenny just drove. We passed so many people that needed help, and we just passed people over some. Just...
It's okay. It's fine. You don't have to say anymore.
I want to go home tomorrow, but even then I can't take away the things Doc went through. Don't you want to go back to the moment before you knew about all of this?
Anybody
in their right mind would. Families and barbecues and beers with good friends.
All of those things.
Those are the things we live for, right? With those gone, what's the point? Back in a bit.
Okay, Lee.
Alright, so we talk to them. Let's talk to the man of the family.
Hey there, Kenny.
How's your son doing?
How's your son doing?
Good, I think. Katya's got a sister up in Memphis. We were coming back from visiting her. We were in a gas station and some guy grabbed my boy. I thought he was kidnapping him. I was on the fucker in about 2 seconds and... Christ. Just lucky I was there. We saw a lot of bodies before we stumbled upon Herschel's. But we're a tough family, Lee. Ain't nothing gonna faze us.
Seem to be very proud of that one.
So what's your family's plan?
Get back on down to Lauderdale and let this mess get sorted out. Government will start handing out shots and the National Guard will do its thing. On the odd chance things got too bad, we could hop on my boat, I guess.
You've got a boat?
Of course.
I'm a commercial fisherman, catching mackerel, dolphin, whatever's biting and paying. Katya wouldn't be wild about it, but the boat's not that bad.
Dude, and it also depends on what kind of beer we're talking about. Like, dude, Dos Equis, you know I'm down for that shit. Or Corona. Be great. Need any help?
Need any help?
No, I think I got it. Do you need any help?
What do you mean?
I mean, in taking care of that little girl. You know what you're doing? You got kids of your own?
No kids.
Nah, no kids.
Would have liked one then.
You're aware.
See ya.
Oh, man. Okay, Brandon, hopefully you can stick around so you can help me make the important decisions. Right now, we're just getting to know everybody. I don't think I can run. Can I run? There's no run button. It's been a while since I've played. Duck!
How you doing, Duck?
Good! I'm gonna drive the tractor! I'm the foreman! Lift with your back, Sean!
Just try to not, you know, break the tractor, bro. Alright.
Hey, Lee.
Need a hand?
Need a hand?
That'd be great. If you could cut those two-bys to length, that sure speed things up.
Hit the timer and I see delayed things from what you do. Oh, whoops, sorry.
My dad doesn't know how bad it is.
No, he doesn't.
I saw a guy in Atlanta kill a kid. A boy. Just shot him right in the face.
Was the boy one of the walkers?
I don't even know. He was either attacking the guy or asking for help. He didn't even hesitate. He just turned, put the barrel of the gun right between the kid's eyes, and pulled the trigger. You don't see things like that. It's not like in the movies.
They don't fall like you think.
Did you have to do it?
Do what?
Kill. Have you had to off one yet?
Oh.
I mean, I'm not gonna lie.
I bashed a poor girl's brains in.
Whoa. I couldn't do that. I'm just glad we're getting this fence built. Dad just wants to keep the family safe and thinks inviting people in is a bigger threat than whatever's out there. How about yours? How's your family?
My parents are in Macon.
My brother and parents are in Macon. I hope.
Oh man, I hope so too. Maybe it's not too bad there. That's probably all I need cut for now. Thanks.
And Sean, thanks again for the ride.
No problem, Lee. Couldn't leave you behind. Anyway, when you see my dad around, he might want some help in the barn.
Okay. It does it really? Dead by Dell is another update. What more do they need an update with? Oh shit. Herschel.
How'd you get out of Atlanta?
I got a ride and then I was in a wreck. I walked until your boy found me.
Well, you're no worse for wear.
This farm's a nice plot of land.
As you told me 20 years ago I'd still be doing this, I would have told you that you were full of crap. Never was a plan, having a place like this.
Yeah, I work tomorrow at 9.
And I guess so was I. Family's important. It's all that matters. You agree with that?
Was brought up to, yes.
Where's your family now? Parents? Wife? Girlfriend?
My parents are in Macon,
with my brother.
Well, I hope they're all right.
You work tomorrow?
But now you've got this little girl to take care of. Clementine, is it? You just stumbled up on her?
I was looking for help in her house.
I was looking for help in her house.
What's up, Herschel?
Can I give you a piece of advice?
Sure.
Sure.
I don't know who you are or what you did. Let's say things don't get better back in the cities, or they get worse before they do. You're gonna have to depend on the honesty of strangers if you're gonna make it. And if those same people get to questioning yours, you're gonna be in trouble. But at least you have the common sense to listen to a man giving you advice.
Oh, you know, it's your house. Oh, shit. Okay.
Gun.
Oh, 12.
I'll get my gun.
I don't know if you're lucky or that sucks. Well, you get to sleep more. You're considered lucky. Time for a big decision. You save the child or you save this guy? Please tell me you're not seeing the lights right now. Child, or save the grown-up. Oh, I made no choice. Oh shit, no. Fuck.
Stitch you up.
It almost got me, man. It, Lee tried to save me.
No!
I know, sir.
He's still screaming, he's safe. What the fuck?
Get out.
Get the fuck out of here!
I'm sorry.
Sorry?
Your son is alive.
You don't get to be sorry.
The fucking screams, I know, right?
But this piece of shit let him die.
Alright, I mean, can you blame him though?
You can't blame Kenny.
The hell I can't.
You watch your back. Wait until it's your daughter and you need his help.
Love your selfishness. She's not my daughter.
Let's go.
Get out and never come back.
Achievement. Rock in a hard place. Chose between two sons. The game kind of gave me the choice anyway.
You've got that ride to Macon if you want it.
I mean, he doesn't seem too happy about it, but we got it though. Woo! Alright. So I know from now on, important choices, I'll pause the game. I think it'll let me. If it doesn't, oh god. I'll try to probably spoil it ahead of time.
Well, this is as far as we're going.
And it's far enough.
Look!
Hey there! You friendly? Truck's run out of gas. Fuck!
It's okay to like animated characters, Brendan.
We're trapped!
What do you think of Big Mate Bang? And what they like. See, I think she's cute. Well, not him. Her. The gun.
Can't take risks like this, and we can't just let people die either. When I say that door stays shut no matter what, I fucking mean it. We don't know who these people are. They could be dangerous.
Worse, they could have led them right to us.
Where the hell is your humanity?
We have kids with us.
I see one little girl.
What about the kid? What about Duck?
What is it?
I have to pee.
I'd go out there again.
In a minute, Clem.
They've got kids, Lily.
Those things outside don't care.
Maybe you should go join them then. You'll have something in common. God damn it, Lily. You have to control these people.
Carly and Glenn just ran out there.
She's the leader here, but it looks like she's losing control of her people.
If you were in my shoes, you'd be the...
Holy shit.
Son of a bitch. One of them is bitten.
He wasn't bitten.
Hell, he wasn't. We have to end this now.
Over my dead body. We'll dig one hole.
No, I'm cleaning him up. There's no bite. He's fine.
Don't you fucking people get it? We've already seen this happen. We let someone with a bite stay in, and we all end up bitten. Shut up. We gotta throw him out, or smash his head in.
Kenny, stop him!
Hey, what do we do about this guy?
Dad, it's just a boy.
All right, so should we side with Kenny, the kid's father, or should we side with the asshole who wants to kill him? I mean, we could try to be neutral about this, but I want to let you make the choice. What do you think? I've already played this before, and I've made my own choice, but I kind of want to see if you are interested in making a different choice than I do. Still there, Brandon? Oh, I just got it. Okay. Trust would be neutral to get trust on both sides. Okay.
Lily, I'll handle this.
Reason with
Dad,
him.
You need to calm down.
We reason with him.
With the bloody end of an axe handle, maybe. Nobody threatens my boy.
Everyone, chill the fuck out!
Nobody is doing anything.
Shut up, Lily. And you, shut the fuck up. They will find us, and they will get in here, and none of this will fucking matter. But right now, we're about to be trapped in here with one of those things.
What the hell are you talking about?
He's bitten! That's how you turn!
He's not bitten. Lee, stop this. It's upsetting him.
Oh, I'm upsetting him. Upsetting is getting eaten alive.
What if this was your daughter?
Never would have happened. She's not some snot-nosed toddler, okay? She's United States Air Force.
What if she wasn't, though?
And her. I'm gonna kill him, Cat. Just worry about Duck.
Lee!
Yeah?
There's someone in there.
It's just locked. Key's behind the counter. Probably.
Hey, I'm not the bad guy here. I'm just looking out for my daughter.
No, you're just the guy arguing for killing a kid.
He's covered in muck. She'll find the bite. Watch.
She won't. And if she does, the first thing he'll do is sink his teeth into his mom's face.
Dude.
Then, when she's dead, he'll probably pounce on your little girl.
Then we deal with it then. But right now, we're just freaking everybody out.
Then get ready to deal with it, because that boy is bitten.
It's not gonna happen.
It is. And we're tossing him out now.
Oh, did I side with Kenny?
You don't touch that boy. You don't touch anybody. I've got a little girl I'm trying to protect in here, too. You want to get violent, you old fuck? Well, come on! You better have a plan to kill me, though, because it's me before anyone else in here!
I'm sorry. I could have let you make that choice, but I...
Jesus!
You actually kicked in. Lee, you're the most clumsiest dude I know. Alright, where am I? Clementine!
Get away from her, you son of a bitch!
Oh, God. Oh, wow, this is hard. It certainly got harder. Oh, there we go. Good thing I blew his mind with my mind. Nah, that's not what happened. You shot him in the head.
You okay?
Just great, thanks.
But for a second there, you thought I did that. remember I protected her.
Everybody down. Stay quiet.
Promise I would take care of her, and I did. But you can die for all I care now. That's not true.
You're gonna get in.
Shut up.
Is that the military?
I don't know.
Thank God for whatever it is.
We almost died because of this bitch and Richie Triggerfinger. That was stupid. That was...
Dad!
What's wrong with him?
What's wrong with him?
It's his heart.
My pills.
Nitroglycerin pills?
Yes, we're out. We've been trying to get into the pharmacy since we got here. Please try to get in there. Behind the counter where the pills are.
We'll do it.
We'll get in there somehow.
Thank you so much. We need nitroglycerin pills. Please get in there. I'll keep an eye on my dad.
Everyone else should get comfy and look for anything useful. We could be in here a while.
I'm starting to think this drugstore isn't a permanent solution.
You're right. This ain't exactly Fort Knox.
What do you suggest?
We need as much gas as possible so we can all get out of downtown Macon. Fast.
Agreed.
And I'll head out and get gas. There's a motel not too far from here, out towards the end of Peachtree. I'll work my way towards it and then loop back, siphoning what I can.
You know your way around?
Local?
Born and raised.
If you're gonna do that, here's a walkie-talkie if you get in a tight spot. Hopefully, you won't need it.
Cool.
Clementine's got the other one. Check in with her and get back here as soon as you can.
And you? What's your name?
It's Lily. My dad's Larry.
Keep a good eye on him. These boys will work on getting you your medicine.
That's right.
And you? You keep an eye on that front door. You're our lookout.
It's Doug. You got it.
And I'm Carly.
Okay, Carly. You'll shift in with Doug when he needs it. For now, get some rest. You're a good shot, and I'd like to keep it that way.
You got it, boss.
Now get him those pills.
That pissed her off. Alright, I could talk to everybody, but...
Central High Tech State. Paper's a week old. Feels like years.
Oh. Let me flirt a little bit.
You're a pretty good shot.
Well, you don't fuck with a reporter, especially one that's 3 days out from her last cup of coffee.
You seem to handle yourself pretty well.
Really? I'm a disaster.
I can't tell.
My news editor was eaten about 5 feet away from me, and I would have joined her if it wasn't for that dorky guy on watch over there.
You gotta be kidding me.
She was an asshole, but, you know.
Yeah.
That guy saved you?
Yeah, can you believe it? Those creeps, or ghouls, or whatever the hell they are, they were pulling our van apart, and that guy, Doug, just came to the rescue.
You can never tell who the heroic ones are gonna be, I suppose.
He's kinda cute. In that parents' basement sort of way.
Oh, man.
Huh? Oh, nothing.
Oh, dude.
How'd you end up here?
We drove up to cover the Cherry Blossom Festival. Real hard-hitting stuff.
Sounds worth it.
What are you messing around with there?
A radio. I can't get it to work, though.
Here, let me have a look.
What could be wrong with this thing? I think I know.
There are no batteries in this thing.
What now?
You know that there are no batteries in that thing.
Yeah, of course. I mean, yeah. No.
I can try to find some. Needs two.
Thanks. I wouldn't even really know what to look for.
Carly, you're too cute. Alright, what's in the food box?
Looks like nobody got a chance to donate anything before this all went down.
Maybe they did and they just stole everything. Oh, ATM.
It's not damaged. Glad this place didn't get looted.
That's the most important thing right now. Clementine! Oh, what is this? Hold on. Oh, energy bar. I'll do this. Let's do this. Hang on, sweetheart. I know there's more here. There it is. That's the office. That's another energy bar. I think there's a battery around here somewhere.
We can't let anything happen to Ducky.
I know.
It's not much, but here. For the boy.
Oh, thanks, Lee. He appreciates it.
That's sweet, Lee.
Hey, Lee. Really gave that old man hell.
Yeah. We got pushed, you know?
You don't have to tell me. I was ready to tear the man's head off. Anyway, we, Kat and I, appreciate your support.
Thank you, Lee.
How's Duck doing?
He's okay. It was just a shock.
We're lucky as hell nobody got nabbed on the way in here.
No kidding.
How's she doing?
I'll have to take a look at her.
She's good, I think.
She's a tough one right there.
She's just a little girl, Ken.
What were you saying, Lee? She spent days surviving on her own?
That's right.
Not just any little girl can do that.
Britain could. I don't know.
What's the plan?
Hang tight, I suppose. Seems pretty dangerous out there, so we ought to wait for things to clear up.
You said your family was from here in Macon?
That's right.
Where are they? Should we go looking for them?
They own this place.
They own this place. They're gone.
Oh, sweetie.
Kat.
They were good people. I wasn't around much.
I don't need my daddy to support me. That's a good one. Oh, man.
Are you guys all right?
We're just fine, considering.
How about you, Duck?
We've all been through a lot.
Lee, you got a second?
Sure. What's up?
Back on Herschel's farm.
Yeah.
I panicked, you know. I'm not proud of it.
It happens.
I guess. But I can't stop seeing him in my head.
Yeah, that's rough.
I killed that boy. We could have saved him together.
You didn't have a choice. You think you do when you look back on it. But in a moment, when things are really out of control, you don't have any choice.
I guess.
Let's console.
Try to let it go.
Before I get to Clementine,
we just need to get back to Fort
Lauderdale. There's a battery right here somewhere.
We'll do our damnedest.
There it is. Battery, credit cards. I think that's the only battery in this building.
No, I'm sorry to hear your loved one was eaten by the living dead cards.
Man, I think you know some people. Family portrait. Okay, let's see.
Try to get some rest, hon.
How can I with those things out there?
Deal with Clementine first. Clementine.
It's not much, but here you go.
Thank you.
Of course. Hey there.
Hi.
Can I get you anything?
I'm okay. Maybe I'm a little hungry.
Still. Huh?
Yeah, it wasn't much.
I know, Clem. I'll see if I can find something else for you.
Any word from Glenn?
Nothing. Is he okay?
Yeah, I think so. You're doing a good job.
We should get to know each other.
So.
Are you okay?
What? Yeah, I'm fine. I just, I'm good.
That's good.
Yeah, I think so. Being good is good, despite the circumstances.
Yep.
We'll sit tight.
Okay.
Oh, man. This is hilarious. The fact that he can't really communicate with this girl is hilarious.
It's not much, but here.
You sure?
Yeah. You're under quite a bit of stress.
Thanks. That's, really sweet.
Don't mention it. How's he doing?
I'm not sure I got your name.
It's Lee.
Lily. My dad's Larry. I was just doing what I had to earlier.
Everyone was.
Now his heart's acting up again and I'm powerless to do anything. And that violence before with my dad, that didn't help.
What's wrong with him?
He's got a heart condition. He takes nitroglycerin tablets pretty regularly. I've seen a few bad attacks trying to keep him relaxed.
You're from here?
I work at Warner Robins, the Air Force base.
Yeah, I know it. Pilot?
Nah, just mechanical admin stuff. I deal with a bunch of shitheads and bureaucrats all day. Sometimes a plane, if I'm lucky. You?
I work up at UTA.
I honestly don't want to talk to her anymore.
Sounds good.
She does not seem interested to me whatsoever. Go on, I'll go back and talk to her, Brendan, but I don't know. I know it's not. I don't need my daddy to support me, that's hilarious.
I can't think about them in here.
Alright. I can talk to you, right, Clem? What's up, Clem?
Everyone out there seem alright to you?
Yeah. Well, maybe not the sick guy.
Yeah. We'll keep an eye on him.
There was that thing in the bathroom. It tried to get me.
I know.
But you stopped it.
Yeah, I did.
Can you do that more?
Well, I'm not gonna go looking for him.
I mean, get the dangerous ones.
I'm gonna try.
Good.
Oh, she's looking up to us.
I'm gonna keep looking around.
Okay.
Alright. Move this pallet.
What's that?
This is my dad's cane. He'd zip around here on it from time to time.
Was he sick?
Nah, he was okay. I actually saw him whoop shoplifters with it. This cane's protected this place better than any guard dog ever could.
That always gives me a giggle.
Like you with your hat.
My dad gave it to me.
See, dads are smart like that.
Alright.
My parents came in here hoping to survive. But it looks like one of them was hurt. I wonder if it was my dad. Trying to be a hero, maybe. Or a protector, at least.
At least. I don't want to look at the alley. Because I just moved this thing on.
Better get this door clear, huh?
Can I help?
Sure. Here we go. Watch your fingers in the drawers.
Scary, huh?
Things have been scary, huh?
Yeah. It's not good. I don't know why everyone is crazy.
Oh, sweetheart.
Neither do I, Clementine. Nobody does, I don't think.
I bet my dad does.
Okay, here we go.
Tough face, though. Oh, God, it's hilarious.
Do you have kids?
No.
You don't have a family?
Let's not talk about that. Do you play sports?
I play soccer, but I don't really like it.
Best sport ever.
I'm not crazy about it either. All right, a little further.
Why don't you want to talk about your family? Do they, like, hate you?
I hope not. It's just complicated.
It's just complicated, that's all.
Why?
It just is.
But you love them, right?
Of course.
Look, my family's gone, and I just wish things would have been different.
Yeah.
I got into some trouble, and I didn't talk to him for a while. This used to be their store. But let's just keep that between you and me, okay?
Okay. Because of the trouble?
Yeah,
oh, yeah.
That's right. Now, let's get this done.
I think it's good to be honest with her.
Ow!
Oh. Whoa.
Are you okay?
I hurt my finger.
Is it bleeding?
A little.
Find you a bandage.
Okay. So now Now we can look through this stuff. Alright, Clem.
Let's have a look at that finger. Ow.
It hurt.
Let's see if we can do something about it.
I could pinch it, but I'm not going to.
Let's
I'm not going to be that
mean.
Let's
get this cut covered up.
Yes, please.
It's locked. We need to track down the keys if we're gonna help Larry.
Lee?
Yeah?
What's up?
What if my parents come home and I'm not there?
They'll find us.
Track us down. Don't worry.
You know how
yeah.
I said I...
Okay. Well, we should keep a lookout. I've got my walkie-talkie in case they try that way.
Stay close to me until then, okay?
Oh, man. All right.
It's the remote to my dad's TV.
Turn on TV. Let's watch some news. Or some porn.
That's what I figured.
Never mind then. No porn for us. I mean, no news.
Luckily, there's nothing I need in here.
Nothing. Nothing at all. Although I look at this.
Find anything?
Oh. Just a
picture of whoever was here.
I know who you are.
Excuse me?
You're Lee Everett. You're a professor at Athens who killed a state senator who was sleeping with your wife. This is your parents' store. Folks around town know the owner's son got himself a life sentence, but I'm a reporter for WABE in Atlanta. I paid attention to that trial. Maybe you're a murderer, but I don't really care. Frankly, that's a skill that might come in handy. Did you tell anyone out there who you were, or that you were tied to this place?
No. I've been sticking to first names for a reason.
You seem like an okay guy, and the last thing we need is drama out there. You've got this little girl to take care of, and... Look, don't make me wrong on this.
I don't plan to.
Good. Because if this lasts longer than a few days, and you're a detriment to the group, then we'd have a problem.
I hear you.
I'll just keep it to myself.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Don't worry about it.
I kind of have to trust her, though. Did I? Well, I told them that they owned the place. I never told them that I killed anybody. How's your finger?
It's okay. Thanks for fixing it.
Everyone's good here.
I'm gonna keep looking around.
Okay.
That's the door, right? Door to form. Yeah, okay.
Wanna head back into the drugstore with me?
Okay.
Wait.
Yeah?
You're not bad, right?
No.
Why are you asking me that?
That lady said you killed someone. Was that because he was one of the things trying to eat you?
No, he wasn't.
No, he wasn't.
Oh. Was he bad?
He was.
Get next to me to the store. Well. Good call on that one. I don't know if that's going to screw me up later in the game. I don't remember. What is this? Oh, this is the gate. I want to look for that second battery because I want to impress Carly. Priorities, man. Okay, now you see a battery over there that I can have?
Hey there. This is Glenn, and I'm kind of in a jam here. Little girl, if you're there, can you put your your daddy on the phone? Or on the talkie or whatever?
This is Lee. What's up?
So, I'm down at that motor inn, and, well, I'm stuck.
Stuck?
Yeah, I saw a chance to get some supplies for the group, and a bunch of the roaming ones got the jump on me. I'm hiding over here, but they won't leave.
What's up?
Glenn's trapped down at the motor inn. Hey, Glenn, we're gonna talk it over and send a group to come get you, all right?
Awesome. I'll sit tight till then.
Sounds good.
Sounds so natural.
Hold on to this until we get Glenn back, okay? I'll take good care of it.
What do you think?
I think Doug's not great around zombies. You got your family here. I'll take Carly and her dead eye down to the motor inn, get Glenn, and get back here as fast as I can.
If that's what you want to do.
Somebody's got to.
Yeah, I'm in.
Good. Doesn't sound too bad there right now.
Let me know as soon as you want to head out. I could use a jog.
All right. Before we get there, though. Before we do that. Oh, what is this? Battery! Yes. So right in front of me all along. All right, Carly. Get ready to be amazed. Where'd you go, Carly? Oh, wait. Wrong.
This battery should fit the radio.
Great. Thanks.
And here's another one.
Should be able to get it to work now.
It's still not working?
Yeah, I can't figure it out.
Let me have a look at that thing.
Carly.
Go ahead.
You're a smart girl. Come on.
Nothing.
Alright. Look, see over here. Get the batteries in there, right? Batteries. Did you put them in the wrong way? Okay. I'll get the antenna up. If you put them the wrong way, that's gonna be the most hilarious thing ever. There we go.
You fixed it.
Continues to spread unchecked. The estimated death toll continues to skyrocket. WABE urges you to stay indoors and avoid any contact with individuals you suspect may have been exposed.
The station is okay.
In the event of a full... My producer's telling me we have to get off the air now.
Steve.
WABE wishes you and your loved ones. God bless you all.
Steve, hey, your boyfriend, Connie. Or... You okay?
That radio sign-off didn't sound too good. Are you okay?
I'm fine.
You don't have to be.
It's traumatic.
I'm sure some people got out. Maybe they're all being rescued. Then again, maybe not.
Alright, let's go talk to Doug really quick.
Heard or seen anything?
Nothing, luckily. Wanna step outside, have a look around?
I'm not suicidal yet.
No, the gate out there is closed. We can hang out in front of the store and be fine.
Oh.
Have a look around.
Let's go have a look around.
Cool. And we'll keep it down. Don't need to bring him back this way with any unnecessary noises.
Agreed.
I mean, if I fart, it's not my fault.
Jesus. Just
eat. As far as I can tell, that's all they care about.
And if one gets you,
they eat you. And whatever's left comes back as one of them.
How the fuck?
I think it might be more than a couple days before all this gets sorted out.
Yeah, I think so too. We better keep it down out of here.
Alright.
I can't reach that brick.
So we can't reach that brick.
Hey, man, what are you doing? We can't even think about going out there unless the keys are out there for sure.
Open sesame.
Hey, man, what are you doing? We can't even think about going out there unless the keys are out there for sure.
Look at the one trapped over there.
Better him than us, huh?
Oh, Everett.
Oh, shit.
What? Do you know that guy?
Kind of.
He has a familiar face.
You're from around here, huh? Could be anybody, you know? They start rotting and get all chewed up and...
Shut up, Doug.
Shut up, Doug.
Look at the uniform, though. He could have worked at the drugstore and died with keys in his pocket.
It would take a lot of effort to make it safe enough to go out there and see if he has the keys. If we could somehow prove that he worked here, I think it'd be worth it.
I'll see what I can find.
I already found it.
That guy over there has the keys.
How can you be sure?
I found this in the office. That boy in the photo worked here. The keys being on him is as good a bet as we could make.
Yeah, I agree. We just need to figure out how to get out there and get them. You wouldn't need long, right?
Nah, just a few seconds.
Maybe there's a way to distract
Chris Nuke, thanks so much for hanging out, man. I greatly appreciate it. Alright.
Think you can do anything with this?
You know what I could do?
What's that?
It's universal. I could program it to work with those TVs across the street. Let's just hope the power's still on.
You can just do that?
Well, I memorized all the codes when I was in AV. Let's try.
Who the fuck memorizes all the codes to that? It makes no sense.
Well, fucking done, Doug. All that dork nonsense might save a life.
Who's I know saying it already hasn't? That got a few of them to take notice.
Not enough, though.
But not enough.
Alright, we're gonna head back.
Let's head back inside.
Okay.
All right. Carly, you ready?
Hey there. You ready to head out?
You got it. You?
Hell yeah.
Yeah.
Let's go.
To the year. Welcome everybody to Oktoberfest, by the way. This whole month I'm gonna be playing scary games. Since, you know, October's familiar with Halloween. Instead of being all nice with candy and shit, I'm gonna scare the living shit out of people. Maybe.
Did you see that?
Or did. Be ready to shoot.
Guys! Oh, man. Glad you're here.
Jesus, Glenn.
Right, that wasn't so hard.
Can we get out of here before any of these things notice us?
Not yet. There's a survivor trapped up there.
No way. We gotta go. Now.
Listen, I was out here looking for gas. And then, up there in the corner room, I heard crying coming from inside.
Thanks, man.
Who is it?
It's a girl. We talked and she got frightened. I was trying to get in and help her and she started yelling and saying I was bitten. I tried to convince her I wasn't, and that's when all these guys came out of the forest. A couple almost got me, and I ended up hiding in the ice machine.
Lucky you. Now let's go.
We can't just leave her.
Damn right we can.
You guys are suicidal over a girl.
I'm saving her, with or without you.
Think about if it was you.
Fine. Let's go save Glenn's damsel in distress.
I need to be sexist about it, Carly. Jesus.
Noise attracts these things. Now let's have a look around.
see. I'm gonna do this.
She's eating something. So we got that one right there, close.
Let's pick this up.
Good luck smothering them to death.
That's not really what I have in mind.
Hoping to feed it to their mouths and choke them to death. I'm gonna go this way. Well, actually, I don't have to go that way. Actually, yes, I do. I do need to go this way. Hang on. I don't know how you guys did it without getting noticed, but sure.
Get out your gun.
But the noise.
Just follow my lead. Stay right behind me.
That was sick.
Dude, keep it down, man. Alright, let's open up the car. Pick this spark plug up. Because I like spark plugs. Don't know what they do, but they work. Put it in reverse.
A sparky thing.
Spark plug. You should hold on to that. Could come in handy.
Let's push this piece of shit. So I got that zombie just like, huh.
That's awesome.
The mirror is that car getting closer. Alright. So we're gonna go. Oh god. Let's go that way. Okay. Oh wait, no. Oh fuck. I fucked it up. I have to go this way now. Just go back over here.
I wonder if there's anything in the pickup.
So I have to like... Oh.
Let me see the spark plug. The porcelain inside these things turns car windows to tissue paper.
It's car windows to tissue paper. I still don't get it. Does anybody know the scientific reason for this? It still breaks the window and it still makes noises. I don't know what the fuck.
That could scramble a brain pretty good.
That's exactly what I was thinking.
I also scrambling a few eggs wouldn't hurt. Kinda hungry. So I think if we go up, it's this. It's gonna be like, I want you to look at me as I kill you. That's mostly everybody. Wow.
Dude, where'd your weapon go?
Into that ice pick sized hole.
Holy shit. It's cool. Now we've got this.
I like how they're talking out loud.
Two more.
That should help.
The epic music, man. Can't let it go to waste.
Why don't you guys lag behind just in case this goes to hell?
Okay. We'll be right behind you.
We're going up. I'm like, I know you. These guys die somehow.
Rat.
Rat-a-tat. Oh, Chris Nuke, thanks so much for the follow, man. I just noticed it. Did greatly appreciate
it. Hello in there. We're here to help.
Please just go away.
Let's go, guys.
In a minute. If you open up, we can take you somewhere safer. We've got a group in town.
No.
Please. She's in trouble.
No. Miss, we're coming in.
She must be really antisocial. All right. Breaking it.
Stop, just stop. I'm coming out.
He is gone. Oh.
You're hurt.
Oh, God.
Appreciate him joining us.
Stay away.
It's pretty cool.
We need to get you help.
It's too late for that.
Guys.
Oh, he's still here.
What?
I told you. I said go away. I'm bit. But you wouldn't just leave.
Let's calm down. You could be fine.
I won't be fine. My boyfriend was bitten. You get sick and you die and you come back and you kill anything you can find.
You have a boyfriend?
What?
I don't want that. It's not Christian. Please, just leave me. Please go.
Dude, she's a Christian. I don't know if you're into Christians, bro.
Come with us, and we'll find you some help.
You have a gun.
So?
Can I borrow it?
What do you mean, borrow?
Give it to me. I can just... you know, end this, and then there's no problem.
Whoa.
Please, I don't want to be one of them. They're satanic.
All right. So what do you guys think? Should I give her the gun, or should I refuse it? Do you want me to have my conscience filled with guilt? Either way, I think it's going to be the same thing. But, let me know, guys, in the chat. What do you guys think I should do? Give her the gun or just say no to her? Give her the gun? Chris Nuke or anybody else in here? You guys, any different opinions? Don't give her the gun. Oh, we got a controversy here. Oh, snap. How do we decide this? Okay. Don't. Oh, wow. Krisnuk really doesn't want to. Alright. Give me your reasons why you don't want me to give her the gun, and give me the reasons why you want me to give her the gun. Maybe from that I can decide a little better. Por qué no? Something happens. If I don't give her the gun, something happens. Brandon, do you want to see what happens, or do you still want me to give her the gun? Boo. Well, it's, but, you know, I want to know. Since something always happens. Alright, well, let's see. You can't have a gun.
Can't you do that to yourself?
Then do it for me!
We need to get going.
Give it to me, please!
This is crazy!
Please, step back.
It's just 2 seconds, just one bullet. And I can be with my family, and it'll...
Miss.
Please!
Oh, shit.
Whoa!
Where'd the gun go?
Whoa, take it easy.
Whoa.
Just want to help.
You can't.
Miss, just relax now. You need to think this through. We'll find you a doctor. It'll be okay. Let's all just...
No!
Oh, man.
Ugh!
must not play a lot of shooting games.
Let's get out of here.
Should have just given her the gun. I mean, I was kind of interested to see what would happen.
Get in!
I honestly don't remember how what would happen if I gave her or didn't give her.
Everyone all right?
Yeah, we had some close
just
calls.
Just one bullet.
Glenn is fine.
Hit a girl at the end of her rope. Yeah, that was an achievement, by the way.
We're okay.
I've got a few cans of gas for your pickup in the trunk of my car.
Good to hear it.
And things back here?
Quiet. Our friend is still in and out over there. He won't survive any more stress.
The next order of business is getting those pills out of the pharmacy.
I like how this... Look at the back of the soda machine. It says thirsty. Like, wow. Creative title. Alright, so I think we got the keys to the pharmacy. I think that's all we need to do now. Oh, wait, no. I don't have the keys yet. Fuck, I need to go get the keys. Got a little ahead of myself there. Oh, let me talk to Clem really quick.
How's your finger, Clem?
Good. It doesn't hurt so much anymore.
Good.
Oh, that's awesome. I know I'm not your dad.
I'm not your dad, but if you need anything, I'm your guy, okay?
Okay. Same.
You're my guy?
Oh, no. You know.
We're gonna try to take care of each other.
Yes. Deal.
Dang it, Lee, you took my joke.
Okay.
Alright. Oh, Glenn, what's up, bro?
How you doing, Glenn?
You know.
Back
at the motor inn.
How can it be that bad so fast?
You know, when things are taken away, people do crazy shit.
I guess. But that's not me. I'm not giving up. Not for anything.
Good, man. Good.
I guess you really wanted that gun.
Seems like...
Why didn't you tell Carly to just give it to her?
People can't be given up yet.
People can't be given up. This will pass.
I'm with you.
I'm glad to hear it. Do you have the combination for the lock on the gate outside?
Why?
Oh, you know, I thought I'd go stretch my legs.
You're probably better off breaking it if you have to.
That is the longest. Okay, I'm not gonna ask what this next move is.
Yeah, right.
Alright. Oh, wait, do I go this way? I believe I go this way. Yeah. Sup, Doug?
How we doing?
Good. Wanna go have a look around outside?
Let's have a look around.
Let's have a look around.
Okay.
Okay, so first things first. New viewer, thank you so much for hanging out. Do greatly appreciate it.
How to distract those things.
Carefully. Hopefully you enjoyed the stream. Welcome to Oktoberfest. This whole month I'm going to be playing some scary games. For you guys to enjoy. Hopefully get scared. If you guys are into that kind of thing. Alright, let's get this brick. And you know, it's not noisy enough yet, so let's break this window. There we go. I gotta admit, Lee has a good arm. And way better aim. Holy shit. I wish I had aim like that.
Now's the time.
Alright, let's go to him.
Be careful.
Keep an eye out, will you? I don't know what happened to Mom and Dad, but I know if you were there, you would have died for them. So, yeah. I'm gonna assume that's what happened.
Did you find them yet?
Give me a second.
God damn it, Doug. I'm sorry I wasn't here.
I'm sorry I wasn't here. But knowing you were to take care of him through all of it, that helped.
Did it help your brother, though? Keys.
God.
Achievement. Hey, bud. Finally reunited with your brother.
Holy crap! Run!
Oh crap. What's the sound of the keys? What triggered them? Oh shit. They're like my dog when my keys jangle every time I have to go to work or something.
Man, that was close.
But we did it. It's all that matters.
Alright, so you had your time to mourn. Let's keep going.
I've got the keys.
Great. God, you're amazing. Let's get there.
Right? Was Clementine with me this time?
Gotta hurry.
I don't know why. I thought it was the same girl who committed suicide. It was like, well, that didn't help her out at all. But now it's a complete different zombie.
Time to go.
I'm gonna get the truck pulled up round back.
Do it fast. I gotta
get ready. Yeah.
I don't plan on dilly dallying. Honey, take Duck into the office and barricade the living hell out of the door behind me. Glenn, when you hear me honking in the alley, start getting people out of here.
You got it.
Doug, Carly, and Lee, you guys make sure our defenses stay up till then. And Lee, I better take that axe in case I run into any of them on the way to my truck.
Here you go.
Right, that door's not locked anymore.
Shit! You three, get on it! I'll get back.
They find out how to open a door. Shit!
Stay away from the windows.
Yo, Glenn.
Hey, Lee. If we don't make it through this, you should know that I think you're a great guy.
Shut up, Doug. No.
We'll make it through this.
I'm not gonna say that to him.
You should know.
I should know what?
Huh?
That I should know.
Shit! On it.
Are you sure?
Shit!
Oh, shit!
Oh, God.
Okay, then. Clementine,
sure.
You look for something to stick in between the handles? Something real strong, okay?
Okay.
Clementine, did you find anything?
Nothing. Wait.
A window is through.
Go!
I'm all on my own here.
I found something.
Yeah, this is not the time to get too emotional about it.
Get out of here!
It isn't obvious. This is the choice I need to make. Do I save Carly or do I save Doug? Let me know what you guys think. I think it's just Only one person here. But let me know what you think. Chris Duke, man, you're awesome. Thanks for hanging out with me. But yes, Carly or Doug? Carly? Yeah, that's what I was thinking. Alright. Sorry, Doug. But she has a gun. Maybe she'll save you, bro. Nice.
Get him off of me!
Doug, no!
God.
Let's go!
They got Doug.
Achievement! Two winter, one leave. Two friends. That is terrible. Go, Clementine. Save yourself.
I'm covered in this, you son of a bitch!
Whoa! Larry, what the fuck, bro? Get
eaten! I'm not letting somebody else get eaten today. Especially a good friend.
Thanks, Candy. I knew I made the right choice to take this thing up for you. Boom! Cavalier Motel. Fucking duck.
Meanwhile, inland, Atlanta has been downgraded temporarily to an 8, with attacks and rioting being reported in all precincts. Citizens are currently advised to stay in their homes or move towards the cities of Charlotte.
What do we do with that picture? I don't even remember what we do with it.
Uncountable severe emergencies in all counties, Georgia's cities and their current level of disaster are as follows. Atlanta, stage 9 catastrophe. Augusta, stage 8.
I think I need to go.
Columbus, stage to Atlanta?
Yeah. I got friends there. And I just can't stay here knowing that they could be trapped in that city.
Sounds like nobody knows what's happening there. When we left a few days ago, could have gone either way.
I gotta take my chances.
What?
Once again, Savannah is now a stage 9 catastrophe. With uncountable severe emergencies in all counties, Georgia's cities and their
dang it, Lily.
Disaster are as follows. Atlanta, stage 9 catastrophe.
Find your friends.
Find your friends. Be safe.
Thanks, Lily. That means a lot. I don't mean to abandon you all, but this seems like an okay setup. And I'm sure things will be back to normal around here in no time.
Let's hope.
You guys be safe.
We'll try.
You be safe too, Glenn. Dramatic silence. Alright. I'm just gonna point it out right now. If it wasn't for me, Glenn wouldn't have made it to the Walking Dead TV series. Just saying that right now. Alright.
Hey, Ken.
Close call back there.
Thanks for picking me up.
No problem. We have to take care of each other.
Yeah, we do.
Hey, about Clementine.
Yeah?
Earlier I said there's some stuff out there that might screw up a precious little girl like her.
You did.
Well, I still think that's true. But after what I saw today, I think between you taking care of her and her taking care of herself, you two are gonna be just fine.
Thanks, Ken.
You got it.
And he seems to be really, really nice to us. I am glad. What the fuck? What's holding me back right now? Whoa, what? We're supposed to... I don't know what's going on. What the fuck? Oh, okay.
How you doing, Carly?
I'm okay. You know, considering.
I do, yeah.
I can't stop thinking about Doug. We couldn't have saved him, could we?
I don't think so. It happened pretty fast.
I know, too it's fast. Stupid. We just met, and he was such a... It's just that I think that I liked him.
No, you didn't. But
I'm
just...
sure he liked you, too.
You better have. Anyway, I'd rather be alone, I think.
I understand.
Wait, Lee?
Yeah?
What is it?
How did you choose? We both needed you. You picked me.
Chris Nuke told me. I'm just kidding.
I was going to help you both.
But you helped me first.
Yeah, I did.
I just wish we both could have made it, you know?
Me too, Connie.
Sick on the kids. You're done. Thanks so much for hanging out, Chris. Did greatly appreciate it, man. Thanks for the follow.
He wasn't. Oh, and then.
Hey, Doug,
hopefully, I'll see you next time.
You wanna cool it for a minute?
Okay, sorry.
I'm sorry, there's not a lot of kids here.
No, it's not that. It's. I got grabbed again.
I was there, though.
I fell, and my walkie-talkie broke.
Aww.
Glenn had the other one.
Oh,
I'm sorry.
I'm sorry.
I'm just looking at the chat.
I know I need to be tough. I'm just sad. I know it doesn't make any sense, but it's how I used to talk to my mom and dad. And now they're gone. It's gone.
Maybe we can find you another one.
I'll just keep this one, I guess.
Lee, come here for a second.
Let me go deal with this.
Oh, man, Clementine, another thing.
God damn it, Duck.
What do you want?
You like my daughter?
It's wrong. Thanks, man. Not really.
Really?
Good. Stay away from her. Where everyone here knows that Lee Everett is a killer. And I'm not talking about those things out there. You hear me?
How do you know
about
that?
I ask you a question, boy.
Whoa, what?
Again, I wouldn't expect a convicted murderer to listen to anything anybody's got to say. I know who you are. And I don't give a shit about what happens to you. But if anything happens to my daughter or that little girl you've got with you, you watch your ass.
I'll make sure Clementine is safe.
Hey,
Lily,
Lee?
That's your problem.
Do you have a second?
Screw the man!
My
I don't like him
be
either.
Dead if it weren't for you.
That guy Doug is dead because of me.
You can't be like that. You're only one man.
I don't know.
We're lucky to have you.
Lily likes me. Oh man, I don't like her though.
I hope that's the sound of us winning this thing.
Me too.
This motor inn's pretty damn defendable. We block off the entrances with some cars, keep someone on watch. Stay here until the military rolls through.
I actually agree with that plan.
Me too.
We got beds,
nice.
We got water, and most importantly, we got light. There are worse places to call home.
Yeah, you're right. You know, guys, I think it's going to be okay.
Well, Lily, you just had to jinx it, didn't you? You dumb bitch. To be continued. All right. That was episode one. Awesome. Next time on The Walking Dead. Achievement. Everything's going to be...
I thought we'd be fine if we survived the walkers. Never expected they'd starve us out.
I want you to have this, okay? In case you or Clementine starts feeling weak.
You don't owe me anything, Carly. How you doing, Clementine?
I'm really hungry, Lee.
We gotta get food, Lee. Soon.
Howdy. I'm Andrew St. John. We're from the St. John Dairy.
It's beautiful.
Don't repeat what happened with the Walkers at Herschel's farm. You choose the kids this time.
Something's coming, Lee. There's gonna be a war.
The Walkers don't worry me as much as the bandits.
You fucked with us! Now we're gonna take what we want! There's too many of them!
Oh, God.
You never liked my dad. Even back at the drugstore when everyone thought Kenny's kid was bit, you went out of your way to side against him.
This isn't happening.
No more, please! No more, please! Please.
Oh. Episode 2, Starved for Help. Oh my goodness. So much shooting and so much stabbing. Alright, honesty. Lie to Herschel. Me and 54% of players were honest. Who would you say? If Doug or Sean? Me and 47% of players chose Sean. I'm assuming the majority save Doug. That's insane. I guess because he's a child. But he's a dumb child. I mean, let's be honest right now. Plus, the game made this a decision for me. Kenny already saved this kid. I'm like, okay, I'll save Sean. Why not? Loyalty. We sided with Kenny. Me and 54% of players defended Kenny. And Mercy gave Ernie the gun. That was her name? I never really found out her name. Me and 52% of players refused the gun. Oh, it's a 50-50 split on that one. Oh, that's interesting. Who would you save, Doug or Carly? Me and 48% of players chose Carly. Many people saved Doug, or is this like a 50-50 thing again? Looks like more people saved Doug. I don't know why. I guess I just really wanted to say, shut up, Doug, a lot. But anyway, that was episode 1. Hopefully you guys enjoyed. Thank you so much for hanging out. I do greatly appreciate it. If you missed any little bit parts of this, don't worry. This will go up to my own YouTube channel. The YouTube channel is Salamander32154. Go check that out. And earlier today I played Dying Light. You can check that in the past broadcasts. And yeah, and now that's also on YouTube. I already have like 2 views in there, which is amazing. But anyway, next time I'll probably be continuing streaming Dying Light, depending on how much time I have, because I know I work tomorrow in the morning, and then I know the next day I work in the morning as well, so I'll have to see how long I can stay up. But next time probably Dying Light, and if not, The Walking Dead episode 2 of season 1. Hopefully I can finish at least season 1 for this month, and maybe play season 2 later in the future, because I want to get to season 3. Oh, you're playing that game? Oh, dude, it's fun. I still need to get the hang of it, but it's pretty fun. But anyway, thank you guys, Chris Nuke. Thanks for the follow. I do greatly appreciate that again. Hope to see you in future streams. And with that said, once again, thank you guys so much for watching. I will see you guys next time. Bye for now.